Hello students, welcome to the new video of ADS subject. In this video lecture, we are going to learn about bubble sort algorithm, which is basically a sorting algorithm which sorts the data. So, in it, we are going to learn about how the bubble sort is work, what is its complexity, what is its pseudocode, and what is program of bubble sort. So, first of all, start with basic introduction. So, bubble sort is a simple yet effective sorting algorithm. Data is placed adjacent to each other. The sort start from the one end, compare two adjacent data and swap them if they are in the wrong order. It will not swap them if they are in the right order. It moves on down the list and continue doing so. When it reaches to the end of the data, it starts over until all the data in the right order. As easy as bubble sort is, it is sometimes ineffective if there is a lot of data. Understand why to use or when to use bubble sort. Not much used in real world, but is a great learning tool because it's easy to understand and fast to implement. Use when a fast algorithm is needed to sort. Understand is fast in term of if an extremely small set of data. Example, trying to get the book on a library shelf back in order. Or, second example, a nearly sorted set of data. Trying to decide which laptop to buy. Because it is easier to compare pairs of laptop one at a time and decide which you prefer than to look at them all at once and decide which was best. Here consider that fast algorithm but very small amount of data. Okay? Second one is when to not use bubble sort. When dealing with a large set of data, it will not be feasible. When you are looking for a quick algorithm, don't choose this because compared to other sorting algorithm, bubble sort is really very slow. Now, let's understood with example. We have a example. We have an array of 6 elements and that array is already sorted here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 are the elements of array. So, for making an example, let's mix it up. So now, this is the unsorted array. And with the bubble sort algorithm, we want to sort it. So, what we will do, we will take first 2 elements and compare them. So, here, our 6 and 5, we have make a pair, 6 and 5, first 2 elements. If they are in wrong order, 5 and 6 is in wrong order. Why? Because if we take 5 and 6 in ascending order, 5 will be first and 6 will be the second. So, that is in wrong order. So, we have to switch it. So, our data will become 5, 6, 2, 3, 1, 4. So now that's better, 5 and 6 in right order. Now what we will do, we will check our another pair, means our 6 and 2. So 6 and 2, again that is wrong order. 2 must be the first and second, 6 must be the second. So we have to switch it, 6 and 2. So our next switch will make it 2 and 6. So now, moving on, we will compare our third pair, which is 6 and 3. So, again here 6 and 3 are in wrong order, so we have to switch it. We will switch 6 and 3 and it will become 3, 6. So, let's move on again. Moving on, our next pair will be 6 and 1. 6 and 1 are again in wrong order. So we have to again switch it. We will make it as 1 and 6. So that is better again. 1 and 6 are in ascending order. It is in right order. So moving on, our next pair will be 6 and 4. So again that is in wrong order. So we have to again switch it. So after switching, it will become 4 and 6. So that is better now. 4 and 6 are in right order. So again moving on, after completing this first step, we have to start it again for second step from the first pair. First pair will be our 5 and 2. So with 5 and 2, we have to check that it is in right order or not. So again, we are checking that 5 and 2, that are on the wrong order. So again, we have to switch it. So after switching, it will become 2 and 5. So that's better now. 2 and 5 in right order. So again, we have to move on to the next pair, which is 5 and 3. So 5 and 3 are again into wrong order. So we have to switch both of them. So after switching, it will become 3 and 5. So 3 and 5 in the right order. So that's better. Again, moving on, we will move to the next pair, which is 5 and 1. Again, they are on the wrong order. So for making right order, we have to switch them. So after switching, that is in the right order. So moving on, let's move further to the next pair, which is 5 and 4. So again we can see here 5 and 4 again are in the wrong order. So we have to switch it. After switching, it becomes 4 and 5. So that is in the right order. So moving on, let's move to the our last pair, 5 and 6. Yes, it is already in the right order. So no need to change them. So again we have to start from the first pair, our pass number 3. Here 2 and 3. Yes, 2 and 3 is in right order, so no need to change them. Let's move to the next pair, which is 3 and 1. Yes, it is in wrong order. So we have to switch them. We will make it 1 and 3. Yes, that's better. Now our this pair is in sorted list. Now moving on to the next pair, which is 3 and 4. So yes, 3 and 4 already in the right order, so no need to switch them. So we will move to the next pair, which is 4 and 5. 4 and 5 already in the switch and already in the right order, so no need to change them. So let's moving on the next pair, 5 and 6. It is already in the sorted, so no need to change them. First, second and third, three passes already completed, but we have to start it again. So from the fourth pass, if we are checking that 2 and 1, then 2 and 1 are in wrong order, so we have to switch them. It will become 1 and 2. That's better now. Again, we will check for second pair, which is 2 and 3. That is already sorted, so no need to change. Moving further to the next slide, which is 3 and 4. 3 and 4 is also into right order, so no need to swap them. Again, we have to move to the next pair, which is 5 and 4. So here, our 5 and 4 already into the sorted list, so no need to change them. Next, we will move to the last pair, which is 5 and 6. So here 5 and 6 both are in the right order, so no need to change them. So here we can say our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is the right order for the earth element. So yes, we have sorted it. So this is the procedure of sorting the array or sorting the elements by the bubble sort. You will need some time to sort different passes. In first part, all elements will not be sorted. You have to sort in different passes. We have taken here four passes to solve or the sort the all the elements. So this is the working of our bubble sort element. Okay, student. So now moving further to the pseudocode of bubble sort algorithm. In pseudocode, here we have a function bubble sort. We are passing list of array and number length of array into the function. There in function we are using a for loop. For loop starting from the 1 and moving to the length of array minus 1 and incrementing by plus 1. In that for loop we have nested for loop. Again this for loop is starting from the j is equal to 1 and to the length of array minus I. Consider here small I. So, and it's again increasing it by 1. In that for loop, we are checking that if array of j element is greater than array of j plus 1 element, means in short, first element is greater than second element. If they are in wrong order, then we have to swap them. So, for swapping our this code is here. We have already studied this swapping code into our C language or data structure or Java, that this is swapping of a number by using third variable. So here swapping procedure is done. And after the ending of if, we have to end of our J loop. If it is not solved or it is not correct, this condition. If this condition is false, then it will be the end of J loop. After the end of J loop, it will again check this condition of for loop. If this condition is true, then it will go for the this for loop. If this condition again true, then it will check this if condition. If this if condition is again true, then it will swap the two elements. And after that false this condition, this will be the end of I loop. And after that for loop, our work is done. So we will return the our array which is already into sorted, and we will end our this bubble sort procedure. So this is a pseudocode. So now let's take a look of our C code or Java code or C++ code for this pseudocode of bubble sort algorithm. So for the code of your bubble sort algorithm, yes, surprise, you have to find it out by yourself. I have given a pseudocode for your bubble sort algorithm that is very easy to implement into a C language or into a Java language or into a C++ language. You have to make your code from this pseudocode. If any query regarding making your code, then feel free to contact me. Okay? So now let's analyze bubble sort algorithm. For analyzing bubble sort algorithm, we have n elements of array. In first pass, we have n minus 1 comparison. In second pass, we will have n minus 2 comparison. Similarly, in the kth pass, we will have n minus k comparison. In the last pass require only one comparison. Therefore, total comparison will be fn is equal to n minus 1 plus n minus 2 plus n minus 3 up to 1. So, total it will be n into n minus 1 by 2. So, by its calculation, it will become order of n square. So, here, by analyzing bubble sort algorithm, we can say it is of order of n square. Okay, so this is analyzing of bubble sort algorithm. This is it for bubble sort algorithm. If you like this, then like, comment and subscribe. Also share it with your friends. Thank you, friends.